Welcome to this new Inside Code video where we will see how to solve the Tower of Hanoi puzzle. First of all, what is the Tower of Hanoi puzzle? The Tower of Hanoi puzzle says, given three vertical pegs and end discs of different size, you're asked to move the end discs from the first peg to the third peg by following three rules. You can move the disc on top of the peg only, and you can move only one disc at a time, and you can't put a disc on a smaller one. If you want to try playing the puzzle, I'll put a link in the description to give it a try. Before starting, you must know something. You must know that we have the source peg, which is the peg A here, is the peg from where we take the discs. We also have the destination peg, the one where we take the discs, is the peg C here. And we have the auxiliary peg, the one that will help us for our task, it's the peg B here. Now we can start. Let's solve the puzzle for n equal to 1, with one disc in other words. When we have only one disc, we just take it from source to destination, from A to C in our case. Now with two discs, to solve the puzzle, we move from A to B, we move from A to C, and we move from B to C. Now for three discs, to solve the puzzle, we move from A to C, from A to B, from C to B, from A to C, from B to A, from B to C, and from A to C. Now for 4 discs, to solve the puzzle, we move from A to B, from A to C, from B to C, from A to B, from C to A, from C to B, from A to B, from A to C, from B to C, from B to A, from C to A, from B to C, from A to B, from A to C, and from B to C. Now we can notice a pattern that is being repeated at each execution. The pattern is, with any value of n, we move n-1 discs from A to B, we move one disc from A to C, and we move those n-1 discs from B to C. And you can verify by yourself that it's what we did each time. For example, with n is equal to 3, here are the 8 steps. And here is the part where we move n-1 discs to B. Here is the part where we move a disc from A to C. And here is the part where we move those n-1 discs from B to C. With n is equal to 4, same thing, here are the 16 steps. And here is the part where we move n-1 disc from A to B, here is the part where we move a disc from A to C, and here is the part where we move those n-1 discs from B to C. But wait, there's something interesting here, because in reality what we are doing in Tower of Hanoi in general is that we are moving n disc from source to destination, right? And we said that in order to do that, we move n-1 disc from source to auxiliary, then we move one disc from source to destination, then we move n-1 disc from auxiliary to destination. And when n is equal to 1, we just move one disc from source to destination. And here is the interesting part. The action inside the function is being called again, so it's recursion. And if we wanted to write the function in code, in Python we would first define the function. It takes n, the number of disks, and it takes the source, the auxiliary, and the destination. The initial value of source is A, the initial value of auxiliary is B, and the initial value of destination is C. Now inside the function, we set the base case. It's when n is equal to 1. In that case, we just move one disk from source to destination. So we print, we move from source to destination, where source and destination are variables, of course. Else, we want to move n-1 disk from source to auxiliary, so we call the function again with n-1, and the source is still the source, but we switch between auxiliary and destination, because now the destination is the auxiliary. For example, we were taking those disks from A to B and not to C. After it, we said that we move one disk from source to destination, so we print, we move from source to destination. Last step, we want to move those n-1 disks from auxiliary to destination, so we call the same function with n-1, and the destination remains the destination, but we switch between the source and the auxiliary, because we were taking those disks from B to C and not from A to C. That's it, we finished our task, and this function will do all the work, and will print all the moves we need to perform in order to solve the Tower of Hanoi puzzle of n disks. Not convinced yet? Let's call this function with n equal to 4. You have the pegs, the output, the code, and the call stack to visualize what's happening. So n is not equal to 1, so we call the function with n-1, and auxiliary and destination switched. N is not equal to 1, so we call the function with n-1, and auxiliary and destination switched. N is still not equal to 1, we call the function with n-1, and auxiliary and destination switched. Now n is equal to 1, so we print, we move from source to destination, and here source is A and destination is B, and we backtrack. We went back to the previous call, and now we print, we move from source to destination, and here source is A and destination is C. Now third step of the call, we call the function n-1 and with source and auxiliary swapped. N is equal to 1, so we print, and we backtrack. Now we finish this function call, so we backtrack. Back to call with n equal to 3, now we print, and we call the function with n-1, and source and auxiliary swapped. N is not equal to 1, so we call with n-1 and auxiliary and destination switched. N is equal to 1, so we print, and we backtrack. We continue in our call, we print, and we call with n-1, and source and auxiliary swapped. N is equal to 1, we print, and we backtrack. We finish this call, so we backtrack. We also finish this call, so we backtrack. Now we went back to the first call, so we finish the first part. Second part, we move one disk from source to destination, we print it. Third part, we call with n-1, and source and auxiliary swapped. N is not equal to 1, so we call with n-1 and auxiliary and destination swapped. N is not equal to 1, then same thing, we call with n-1, and auxiliary and destination swapped. Now n is equal to 1, we print, and we backtrack. Now in this call, we print, and we call with n-1, with source and auxiliary swapped. N is equal to 1, we print, and we backtrack. The call ends here, so we also backtrack. We went back to n equal to 3, we print, and we call with n-1, and source and auxiliary swapped. N is not equal to 1, so we call with n-1, and auxiliary and destination swapped. N is equal to 1, we print, and we backtrack. Now we print, and we call with n-1, and source and auxiliary swapped. N is equal to 1, we print, and we backtrack. This call has no more instructions, we backtrack. Same thing for this one, we backtrack. And same thing for the original call, we backtrack. And our process ends here, and you can see that we solved the Tower of Hanoi puzzle. And we even got all the moves to do, the power of recursion. For the time complexity, here we have a recursive function, and each call is calling the same function twice. So we have the initial call, it calls the function twice, then each one of them calls the function twice, and so on. So it will give us a time complexity of O of 2 power n. And for the space complexity, it's a recursive function, so we need to have a look on the call stack maximum size, which is equal to n here, because there can be at most n calls on the call stack, so our space complexity is O of n. I hope that you found this video interesting. You can find the code in the first link in the description, and see you in the next video.